First question will be, why, Mr. Ambassador, did the U.S. Embassy voice its concern publicly?
Well, for the reasons stated in the press release, I think this is an important benchmark requirement that the EU has placed upon Romania, that it have such an agency. But beyond that, any integrity regime anywhere in the world, including in particular in the United States, requires financial disclosure of public officials and has a system in it by which violations of that regime becomes a question of prosecution or sanction of some sort. So it's just a fundamental process. Every democracy, functioning democracy, needs something like this. And we have in the United States have found it to be extremely useful. We've had it for many, many years.
Would you please, Mr. Ambassador, elaborate a bit, why is the U.S. Embassy, why is concerned about the future of ANI? Could you be more specific on that?
Well, the U.S. Embassy is concerned about all these transparency and rule of law issues because we have American entities and citizens who are active in Romania in a number of respects. We have American companies that are here. We have American NGOs that are here. And they want to know that the rule of law will be applied to them and to all Romanians. And because we are also invested in the future of Romania as a free market and as a functioning democracy, and rule of law is basic to free markets and democracy.
For ordinary people, could be hard to understand the link between having a national integrity agency and the fact that you have foreign investors here and U.S. citizens here. I mean, what would be the direct link between these two
things? In the United States, we have a special requirement called the Foreign Corrupt Practices Act, which basically says that no U.S. company, no matter where it is in the world, can offer extra money or bribes or gifts to foreign governments for any purpose. Many other countries do not have that rule, so we are not on exactly a level playing field. And some of our competitors, even here in Europe, play by other rules. We would like to have a level playing field, and the way to have a level playing field and be sure our companies are treated the same as any other company is to be sure that the rules that apply to all actions in Romania with respect to companies or average Romanians are the same, and that there's, you know, the less corruption and the more transparency and the more the rule of law is applied equally and fairly, the better off for all Americans who are operating here. But it's also better, obviously, for all Romanians. I might point out to you that I've seen some polling numbers that show that young people here in Romania list corruption and the fact that the rule of law does not apply as one of the main reasons they're thinking about leaving Romania. And I'm telling you, if Romania loses its young generation of entrepreneurs and scientists and artists, its future will be in doubt.
That's right. And I'm insisting asking you this because the Constitutional Court decided 2 years ago that some of the powers of CNSAS, another important institution, were also unconstitutional, were declared 2 years ago, and I do not remember any reaction from U.S. Embassy at that time. And my question will be, why is the National Integrity Agency future more important now than the case of CNSAS was 2 years ago?
Well, I wasn't here 2 years ago, and I don't know the reasons. I didn't study that court decision. I do know that ANI was an important part of Romania's accession to the EU, and it has become part of the benchmark the EU has set for Romania. I don't know if that former agency was or played any role in that, and in that respect alone, it's enough for me to convince me that it's critical to the future. And I've gotten to know the director of ANI a little bit. I've followed what they've been trying to do, and I think they're trying to do the right things. And so I can only speak to this agency and this court decision.
His Excellency, the Ambassador of the United States of America, is our special guest at the Monday discussion. We saw many comments and reactions after the Constitutional Court decision regarding ANI, saying that it's not a big deal because the institution has anyway limited power. What is your comment at this point?
Well, it does have limited power, but to take away those limited powers that it does have undermines the whole regime that was set up to guarantee transparency and openness and public disclosure. If there's no sanction for not telling the truth on your public disclosures, who's to say that you'll get any honesty in what is being disclosed in these financial statements? And the notion that these financial statements can just stay in the agency and not be publicly disclosed, that somehow this is a violation of privacy, is troublesome to me. In the United States, we have a basic rule on privacy that you have to have an expectation of privacy. In other words, a public official, someone who runs for office, should have no expectation of privacy with respect to his or her financial resources and where they came from, because people have a right to know whether you're getting extra resources from some other source.
By the way, one of the reason of the one of the arguments of the mm-hmm. Constitutional Court was the law is breaking the privacy
right.
in Romania.
Well, I just gave you what I think is the right answer to that, that there is a right to privacy, of course. That's fundamental to all civil liberties, certainly in the United States as well. But the basic rule is that you have to have an expectation of privacy. You have an expectation of privacy when you're in your bedroom. You don't have an expectation of privacy when you're on the public street, okay? You don't have an expectation of privacy. I don't have an expectation of privacy sitting in this interview here. Everything I say is going to be picked up on this microphone and on that television. And when you run for public office or you hold a public office, you should have no expectation of privacy with respect to your financial resources. And besides, the law is very clear on that. In Romania, it's clear as to what's to be publicly disclosed. And, you know, any regime of integrity requires that kind of standard.
By the way, what are the laws saying in the United States about politicians, for example? They are forced to declare their fortune, their income, mm-hmm. and everything?
Yes, and as a matter of fact, me as a U.S. ambassador, I have to list publicly all the assets, not only of myself, but of my wife. I have to list any income that I've had, not only this year, but for the last 2 years prior to this, before I was even a public official, I have to list that information.
Including information about accounts, about
yes,
your accounts?
Yes, absolutely.
Detailed information
yes,
about
absolutely,
your accounts?
Yes, absolutely, yes. And all public officials have to do that in the United States. Now, some public officials have different rules than others, depending on which branch of the government you're in, but in all branches of government, you have those rules. And on the court system in the United States, you have the similar disclosure. Incidentally, all the judges make those disclosures as well. And
you don't have a problem with privacy being broken?
No, there's no expectation of privacy with respect to this kind of information because they're public officials.
That's right. What are the topics of concern for the U.S. Embassy are here in Romania that make you consider a possible public position eventually?
On this issue?
No, on other issues, if you have.
Well, I have basically one standard or two standards that I apply in all of these cases. If there is a place, well, the fundamental issue is what are the integrity issues that relate to U.S. companies and U.S. citizens in the first instance? If I see things happening with respect to the people I represent that I believe needs to be raised with the government, I initially raise them with the government. If the government is not able to answer them or they present difficult issues that require public expression, as in this case, I do. And when the government takes a position that I think is right, as they have here with the executive branch trying to fix this problem, I want to be supportive. I'm very supportive of what Minister Prodoiu and President Băsescu are trying to do here, which I gather is to fix this problem. And one of the reasons I wanted to be on this program today was to say that.